And they would ask me, what kind of place do you want to be at if you were to be president? I would describe the kind of place, and most of them would say to me, you're describing your own campus. That's right. So this is not an accident for me to be here. It's a deliberate choice and one that I'm very excited about. There are so many things that are going well here, in part due to Dr. Hefner's leadership and the work of members of this campus. I'm not stepping into a role where there are huge things that need to be fixed. This is a place where we have strong enrollments, where we have exciting physical plant improvements going on that will affect the learning environment here and affect the opportunities that students have on campus and in the community. In the presidential profile, there was a statement that a goal for Fredonia's next president would be to bring Fredonia to a point of some distinction among the comprehensive colleges. I think that's a pretty modest goal. I would like to see us do much more than that and to be recognized for the distinction we have, not just in Western New York and not just in New York State, but even nationally for the kinds of things that happen here that I think make it an ideal place for students to attend. The work that went on last semester in identifying baccalaureate goals to see what we promise students they will learn if they earn a degree here should be an exciting way to reimagine our curriculum, our general education, and our majors, so that students leave here with a clear sense of the value of their Fredonia education. We have accreditation that has gone well, but gives us an opportunity to ask about specialized accreditation. I'm going to keep my remarks pretty brief because I think that after Dr. Hefner speaks, you may have questions for me, and I'll be glad to answer some of those. But I'd like to thank you very much for coming here today. Seeing all of your faces, as I said, makes this real for me and even makes me more excited about what's ahead starting on July 1st. Thanks so much.
Yesterday, I had the pleasure of watching her on my computer. It actually was on Denise's computer. We were all gathered around watching on her computer. She's got a bigger screen than I do. And we saw the board vote unanimously for Ginny. And when I saw that vote, that was no surprise to me. She is very deserving of this position. For the past 7 years, I've had the pleasure of working side by side with her on so many different activities, and I know firsthand how much she cares about this university, about this community, and especially about our students. She was fully involved in every key meeting as a new science center was being designed. She's been directly responsible for hiring nearly 100 SUNY faculty that we currently have here on campus. She served as the leader of the SUNY Chief Academic Officers Group and has been responsible for the smooth operation of academic affairs, which represents about 70% of the SUNY Fredonia budget during four of the most difficult budget years this campus has ever faced. And I wanted to just conclude my remarks one more time by asking all of you to congratulate the new president of SUNY Fredonia, Dr. Virginia Horvath.